If you go to Wikipedia or if you go to any of the jazz sites, there are real conflicting reports and conflicting versions of what happened that night. And I really think for the first time we're going to be able to solve a lot of the mysteries.
At the beginning of piecing together the history of Concert by the Sea, it wasn't clear where exactly it was recorded. There were some sources that said it was recorded at an army base. So the very first thing was to try to figure out where he played. And through doing that, we learned that it was recorded at the Sunset Center, which is still there.
We now know that it was recorded as a concert for Voice of America, for the Armed Forces Radio Network.
And then in terms of the archive, uncovering the actual contract that was written for Erroll to perform there, which was promoted by Jimmy Lyons, who actually also helped to start the Monterey Jazz Festival. That was a cool connection that we found.
There are a number of people who claim that they recorded the show. And going down the two different roads, we found that in fact they did it together, that Will Thornberry and Jim Meagher were actually there. So they need to edit their Wikipedia pages now, put each other's names in it.
The concert was recorded by Meagher Electronics, which in later years recorded the Monterey Jazz Festival, and actually found out that the Monterey Jazz Festival would have happened as a result of Jimmy Lyons working on his series Jazz at Sunset, which produced Concert by the Sea. So there's a direct connection between Concert by the Sea and the Monterey Jazz Festival.
We've been able to uncover and answer a lot of the mysteries surrounding this recording. It's funny, with great recordings like this, there usually is some part of it that people can't really figure out. And so people will finally be able to now know the story the way it actually happened.